What a way to start the Rumble.
Introducing the first entry from Cleveland, Ohio, weighing 220 pounds, The Miz.
Now, The Miz lost to R-Truth Monday night on Raw, so he's assigned the number one spot here in the Royal Rumble match. But I believe by the next time we come your way on pay-per-view, 3 weeks from tonight, it is the Elimination Chamber in Milwaukee, Wisconsin. I think this man, The Miz, will have gone coast to coast by the time we get to Milwaukee. Have gone from one all the way for 30 and won the Royal Rumble matchup and headed to WrestleMania.
About a suck up. Come on, I mean, give him a little bit more build up than that.
You know, Cole, if brains were rain, you'd be a desert. If you think The Miz is gonna last this entire Royal Rumble,
every superstar backstage has been snickering at me all day. They think I'm actually bothered by the fact that I'm the number one entrant in the Royal Rumble match. They think it scares me. They think I'm intimidated by it. They don't think I will make it to the end. But those are the same people, the same superstars that told me I would never main event WrestleMania, that I would never be in the main event, that I would never be in this ring a WWE champion. Every time they have denied me, I have went above and beyond and proved them wrong, and tonight will be no different. I may be the first one out here, but I will be the last man standing. And I will go on to headline WrestleMania 28. Because I'm The Miz. And I'm awesome.
So The Miz, ladies and gentlemen, set to participate in his fifth Rumble match of all time. Who enters at number two? None other than Miz's former protege.
This is the second participant from Washington, D.C. Weighing 236
all right,
pounds,
go to wrestling,
Alex Riley.
And again, as Alex Riley gets set to take on his former mentor, I want to remind everybody again, next time we're on pay-per-view, 3 weeks from tonight, the Elimination Chamber, Milwaukee, Wisconsin, the final pay-per-view before WrestleMania.
I guess it's appropriate that this is The Miz's first opponent here, because I think Alex is the first friend that Miz stabbed in the back, wasn't he?
Well, no, it's the first piece of trash that Miz threw out.
You said it right, King.
Remember, Miz was the mentor of Alex Riley. Started Alex Riley on his career, on his road here. Really was a role model for Riley before Riley turned his back on
the
Miz.
The better Alex Riley got, the more jealous the Miz became.
Tell it like it is. Miz used this kid as much as he could for what he was worth, and he got rid of him. That's what he did.
I just think Alex Riley didn't treat the Miz with any respect. Nonetheless, here we go. First two men of the 2012 Royal Rumble, the silver anniversary. And here we go. Strategy, guys, for the first two men out of the box.
Survive.
Exactly right. There is no strategy in the world. Just last as long as you can, and hopefully you'll be the last man standing, like Miz said.
Hey, guys, Alex Riley just turned the Miz inside out.
Yeah, and remember the rules. You're eliminated when you go over the top rope and both of your feet hit the floor.
The last the test of time to weather the storm, you know, from the first man in, Miz got his job cut out for him tonight. Hopefully he got a ginseng and his raw jelly, because it's gonna be a long night, dog.
Already, huh? Is this you? Oh, is this you? You remember me, kid? Remember me?
Huh? Miz trash talking Riley early on, and Alex
That was close.
And there goes Alex Riley is eliminated.
That was an experience right there. That kid just, I mean, a step off right there.
Yeah, the Miz eliminating Alex Riley. One man down, 28 to go for the Miz.
Inexperience on A-Rod's part right there. Next year be a better year for A-Rod.
You know, you asked about the strategy, Cole, when it was one-on-one. That's your best opportunity in the Royal Rumble, when it is just one-on-one. Because the more crowded that ring gets, your chances go down.
Only two men have gone from number one
to actually win the Royal Rumble matchup. One of them, 1995, Shawn Michaels. Great interview on WWE.com with Shawn Michaels right now. Advice for The Miz on how to survive from number one.
The truth has set me free.
Here we go. Entry number three. Former friend, former buddy,
former homies.
R-Truth. He beat The Miz Monday night to avoid being number one, but, well, Truth didn't get much better of the draw here, coming in at number three.
About that.
Oh, double leg. Sweet double leg. Truth coming in. Taking care of business.
And here
tonight.
We go. R-Truth in his fifth Royal Rumble match of all time as well. And Miz and Truth going at it. Former friends and buddies.
Oh, look at that.
Went through a lot together.
Beautiful.
And there's the athletic R-Truth taking out Miz early on.
What's up is right. Here goes what's up.
Truth back in rap form tonight, baby.
R-Truth looking to eliminate Miz early on. Miz hanging on, though. R-Truth said in an interview that Miz is, quote, no HBK. He's The Miz and he's awful. And Miz was going for the skull-crushing finale, his finishing move there. Ooh, and R-Truth missed.
Smart move right there by The Miz.
Again, these two know each other so well. They were great tag team partners for a time.
Well, you say
R-Truth. Whoa.
Oh, look at this. Miz in deep trouble. What's R-Truth going to do here?
Wow. Miz just took one right there, but R-Truth muscles that boy up right there,
yeah,
dog.
Yeah, but you know, a move like that, I mean, it'll help you, but you got to get your opponent over the top rope and both feet on the floor.
Miz survives again as we await entry number four. The Intercontinental Champion, Cody Rhodes. And guys, I said on SmackDown this past Friday night, Rhodes my dark horse to win this thing. I think Cody's got all the tools and he's got some great Royal Rumble history. And Cody Rhodes, beautiful disaster kick to the back of Miz's head.
Wow.
Glanced off R-Truth as well. And Cody Rhodes coming out like a ball of fire. And you gotta remember, folks, back in 2008, Cody Rhodes lasted 23 minutes in this event before being eliminated by Triple H. In 2009, Cody Rhodes lasted 37 minutes and was one of the final four men in this match.
You know, this is supposed to be every man for himself, but you can see what's happening here. A quick partnership being formed by Cody Rhodes and The Miz.
That's what Cody's all about. I mean, if this kid can get an edge, trust me, he'll take it. But as soon as he get that edge, he will stab you in the back in a minute. You better watch yourself out there, man. Watch yourself, Miz.
Yeah, Miz again. Remember, this is every man. Oh, look at this, Cody hanging on. Remember, this is every man for himself in this matchup. Cody's got to get back into the ring in a dangerous position, hanging on by the apron.
You said Cody Rhodes better watch himself, Booker. If you ask me, it looked like The Miz was kind of sneaking up behind Cody.
Wow.
Uh-oh. And there's The Miz as we await entry number five. Justin Gabriel from Cape Town, South Africa, the high flyer.
This kid's got a lot of energy. Looking forward to seeing what Justin brings to the table.
Yeah.
And here it is, right here.
And there it is. Justin, who's had an issue with Cody Rhodes the past couple of weeks on SmackDown, a part of just his second Royal Rumble match of all time.
Well, one thing this does, it kind of evens the playing field and it takes all the heat off of R-Truth there for a couple of minutes.
Definitely.
At least.
Justin Gabriel coming here totally on fire. And this kid got a lot of high-flying moves. You got to watch this kid because he'll go up top in a heartbeat.
But the problem is, Booker, with Justin Gabriel and that high-risk offense, got to be very careful that he doesn't get up in that top rope area where he can get himself eliminated.
Yeah, you gotta change your strategy in the Royal Rumble.
I tell you, it don't take but a second to be out of position in a matchup like this, and it could be all over for you.
So again, you gotta go over the top rope and both feet touch the floor before you're eliminated.
Four men in this matchup, as you can see, Miz and R-Truth, Cody Rhodes, and Justin Gabriel. One man's been eliminated thus far, that being Alex Riley. Five men have entered.
The last man standing in the Royal Rumble. Oh, goes to WrestleMania.
Gabriel and Cody is going one-on-one, baby. And it's looking good. Oh, my goodness.
Awaiting entry number six.
5 seconds away. Who's it going to be?
Oh, what happened? The tag team champions there is Primo.
That's Primo right there, dog.
Primo and Epico, of course, the cousins of the current tag team champions of the WWE. And Primo
would he have at least brought Rosa Mendez with him?
That's what I was looking for when I heard that news.
Yeah, but look at Primo go, entering at number 6. Nice move there. Oh, ouch.
Like I said, guys, a matchup like this, I mean, being in the right place at the right time. Oh, my beautiful move.
This Primo is amazing to watch.
Primo's got a lot of
balls. There's where that high-risk offensive style
hurts. R-Truth.
R-Truth rolling, knocking Cody down. And there goes Miz.
Oh, that goes R-Truth.
Miz eliminates Truth.
Right after that score, Cork's elbow was a little dazed and confused, man.
Yeah, look at Truth.
Yeah,
that's what I'm talking about. Now look at that. Now listen, Miz has not been eliminated, guys.
Okay, we know.
He went underneath the bottom rope, not over the top.
At least he got what he had coming.
So Miz is still in this matchup, but he may be out cold.
I have to take that move right there. He may not get up for tonight.
Miz ate a little floor there, courtesy of R-Truth. I like it.
So Truth's been eliminated. We've got a Primo, Justin, Cody, and The Miz. Still part of this matchup as we await entry number 7.
It's gonna be.
This is gonna be a car wreck, all right.
Oh, here we go, baby.
Mick Foley, the 3-time WWE champion.
Hardcore legend, baby. Mick Foley has hit the ring with a vengeance.
And listen to this crowd. That's not a cheap pop. That's a real pop.
Mick Foley in his 4th Rumble match of all time. Remember, he was placed into this matchup out of the kindness of John Laurinaitis' heart this past Monday night on Raw.
Okay, another thing John Laurinaitis did right. Makes 2 out of his career.
What?
Oh, that goes Primo. Cody trying to take advantage of a Mick Foley right here, but it ain't happening.
And Mick Foley again, look at him go. He said he believes in magic.
Oh, those right hands. Trust me, I know how those right hands feel.
He said magic may be in the air tonight. He wants to go to WrestleMania.
Bang, bang. He just hit it.
I wish he would have bang-banged himself.
Oh, that finished Mick Foley right there, baby.
Get him up, Mick. Get him over.
Oh, look at that double DDT. Mick Foley.
Mick looking good.
Mick looking to win this whole thing, man.
It came in. What number is Mick's number?
Number 7.
Number 7? Could be a good test to Mick's stamina here tonight.
Exactly. I mean, his cardio can't be 100% these days, but Mick Foley is experienced.
Oh, hey.
What the hell?
He's back! What is that?
What the hell? He got an old 280 Datsun 280ZX. Worth about $600.
Is that Ricardo?
Wow, finished 1985 dots.
I guarantee you the anti-theft device is the way it looks. Proud of that car.
Well, at least he's got something to ride.
Twin brothers from different mothers.
Look at this guy. I've seen better heads on a pimple.
Listen to the Ricardo chants.
Nice love handles.
I thought I was in bad shape. Get on a treadmill. Wait. You look like Ricardo was trying to work out some sort of strategy with Mick.
Mick might like this guy's car.
Yeah, Mick would be right home, and he looks like a homeless guy.
Check it. I mean, look at Rodriguez. He looks like he's in a pair of drawers.
Oh, there goes Gabriel! You gotta love it! Oh, this guy is my favorite superstar.
He would be.
And who is gonna be number 9? got even more goofy. The assistant SmackDown, the assistant to the SmackDown general manager.
Here comes that power walk. Tina Morello.
Jerry, remember last year? Morello was one of the final two men remaining in the Rumble match. In 2009, he actually set the record for the shortest time ever in a Rumble match, 1 second.
Ricardo.
Oh, the cobra!
Whoa, 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 whoa.
Santino having some fun with Ricardo.
A couple of inverted atomic drops and... What?
That was unique. Chain wrestling, right?
Yeah.
Oh no! Oh, hey, the world's biggest wedgie.
Yeah, I know how that feels. Oh, Ricardo CMI. Doing?
You didn't tell me you was in a key.
Where are you going?
that championship, getting that shot will make you do something crazy,
come on,
man.
Booker. I mean, he's just basically taking away another spot from somebody in this roster that deserves one.
Hey, man, this is the king. I mean, he gets an injury just being the king. What are you talking about?
I mean, why is he in this matchup? Can you imagine Jerry Lawler main event in WrestleMania?
Yeah, I can imagine it. I can imagine him being the champion as well.
I'm sure you can. And look at Lawler and Miz, who've had a long-standing rivalry.
Big slam by the King. King, drop it on him, baby. Drop the strap. That's my
Lawler wish. Has no business being in his match.
I
want to
see the King drop the strap. I want to see him drop the... Oh, here we go.
Come on.
Finish King right there, baby.
Now you're stealing my lines. Thank you, Cody. Great job, Cody. Serves him right. Now you come back here and do his job, what he's supposed to be doing. Instead of there playing like he's going to WrestleMania.
King did a hell of a job right there, man. He almost stayed in there and pulled it out.
As we await entry number 13, no announcer should enter the Royal Rumble match.
Why not?
Because we've got a job to do out here. It's hard enough keeping track of all 30 entrants.
There would be no stop.
And here is Ezekiel Jackson.
Here comes Big Zeke. This kid is looking for a breakout moment. Could the Royal Rumble be it, King? You did a hell of a job, son.
And here's Ezekiel Jackson, personification of domination.
You did a hell of a job, King.
Look at that on the bright side. You lasted longer than the 4 seconds you did 14 years ago. Nice try. What are you thinking about anyway?
I'm thinking about going to WrestleMania, just like every other superstar in the WWE. What are you talking about?
Can you do your job now and call the action with Ezekiel Jackson in this?
King, you make me wish I'd have took that invitation and jumped in myself, dog. Yeah, you did a hell of a job. You did a hell of a job.
And remember, ladies and gentlemen, The Miz has been in this matchup since number one. He's been in the Royal Rumble match for over 18 minutes so far.
I'm going to tell you, this kind of match right here is set for Big Zeke. This is the type of match he can make a breakout moment here in the WWE. Let's see exactly what happens.
Zeke. Wow, what a side slam.
Zeke, start throwing them suckers over the top rope, man. What are you waiting on?
And Jackson just pounded away on everybody in his path.
Hammer those guys.
Did anybody tell Zeke the rules?
Yeah, you got to eliminate your opponent.
You got to put him over the top of the
Yeah, he's trying to do that here.
I'm just wondering.
As we await number 14.
Number 14. This number right here probably is going to be a lucky number.
Well, there he is.
There we go.
Jinder Mahal.
Talking about money.
The Sikh Punjabi. And, of course, wearing the, well, it's called the Pundri, which is actually on his head there. The maroon color means he is affluent.
I thought it was called a turban.
No, it's a puggery. That's what these Sikhs call it. Nonetheless,
he's got so much money, Booker, he's got a Persian rug made out of real Persians.
It is worn by warriors and saints and soldiers. And Jinder Mahal slowly taking his time to the ring as Ezekiel Jackson, who's had his issues in the past with Jinder Mahal. You see what Jackson has done. Kofi, Miz, and Cody are all down in the center of the ring.
Mahal taking his sweet time to get that turban off, man. Don't want to.
Well, of course, it's a very, very important object.
Yeah, I just don't think he's in a hurry to get in there.
It protects their hair, keeps it clean.
What?
It does. That's what it's used for. And Jinder Mahal now going right after Ezekiel Jackson.
Oh, man.
With a neck breaker in Mahal, taking it to Kofi Kingston. Miz and Cody and Zeke and Jinder and Kofi. Still in the Royal Rumble match 2012.
I mean, these young guys in here going, you know, all out trying to win that shot. And that's really what it's all about, trying to win that shot to get that title shot. Now, I'm going to tell you, if I had a chance to be out there, I would be out there too, man.
Uh-oh!
Here we go!
Ladies and gentlemen, the great Khali, the brother-in-law of Jinder Mahal. And they do not get along. Khali was taken out in Mark Henry's Hall of Pain back in September. And now he's going after the man, Jinder Mahal, who has treated him horribly ever since Mahal has come to the WWE. Khali entering his sixth round match. He's 7'4", 445.
Check it out.
Look at the size of Khali. And now he turns his attention to Mahal.
First one out right there.
And now Zeke. trying to take it to the big man.
Big man, Zeke is huge, but he's dwarfed by the great Khali.
And there goes
Zeke. Big Zeke just got took out of the game, dog.
I think there's a new favorite in the Royal Rumble.
Yeah, he's eliminated Mahal and Jackson. His name is the great Khali.
Get the Miz and get Cody.
Cody and Kofi, Khali and Miz.
There goes Cody Rhodes, he's gone.
Yeah. Oh, come on, Cody, hang on in there. Hang on there, Cody. As we get ready for entry number 16,
man,
who's it gonna be?
You talking about action, guy. This thing is action personified tonight.
We are more than halfway.
Sabes que nosotros somos pocos, pero locos.
Oh!
Que en la calle somos los más poderosos.
Check it out on that Will Rider bicycle driven by Camacho. It is Utico. Entering at number 16.
A low rider bicycle. That thing looks worse than Ricardo's car.
Is Camacho just giving him a ride to the ring right here? What?
How can you say that? That low rider bicycle is outfitted in gold. Gold spokes on that bike. Look at Utico, a high flyer, taking it right to Kofi Kingston here. Utico after the Miz, and Utico's rolling.
I really like this kid, Utico. I mean, this is the real WWE. He's making a move like no other, man.
Well, he's got some moves, all right.
Oh! Just took one right there, though.
But the great Khali has that huge right hand when he chops your head off.
I'm gonna tell you, man.
You're done.
Stay away from the great Khali, because right now he's dropping that hammer.
Please, somebody. Cody is.
Cody Rhodes as well, having a great Royal Rumble matchup so far. Cody Rhodes, who entered at number 4, has been in this match well over 20 minutes.
You know, I just want to see somebody get Cody beat, man.
Of course you do, but Cody's still in this thing.
About that kid,
as we get ready for number 17.
Who's it gonna be?
Can you dig it? Sucker.
What? Now you? You gotta be kidding me!
Yes, sir!
Now you?
Go get him, Booker! Go get him, sucker!
What are you doing?
What do you think, Cole? Look at this!
And he's going right after Cody! What business does Booker T have to be in this matchup?
What do you mean, what business? Booker T could go to WrestleMania, baby! He's been a champ before, he could do it again!
Uh-oh, yeah, but he just ran face first into the great Khali. And again, just like you, Booker should be doing his job out here as a commentator.
What do you mean? Booker's still a superstar?
Didn't he learn his lesson when he had that rivalry with Cody Rhodes last month?
I thought Booker T took it to Cody Rhodes every time they locked up.
Here, the Booker T chance for some reason out of this WWE universe.
Did it almost make you barf when you heard the King chance while I go?
Yeah, it made me sick to my stomach. You think you'd be out here doing your real job instead of trying to play superstar?
You're just trying to do your job and watch Booker T go in there.
Well, he's in there. And so's Miz, who's lasted longer than anybody, coming in at the number one spot.
Whoa, look at this!
And Kofi Kingston. Skin of the cat, Miz is in trouble! Oh. Kofi still alive, hands on the floor. Remember, both feet have to hit the floor. Oh my God, dangerous
situation. Whoa, look at this!
Oh my God!
Look at this!
Are you kidding me?
He saved himself!
Are you kidding me?
Kofi Kingston, what a move!
That has got to be the greatest thing I've ever seen!
Even you admit it, huh?
That has got to be the greatest thing I've ever seen in the Royal Rumble match.
Kofi Kingston facing sure elimination from the Miz, and he walked on his hands!
And here comes Dolph Ziggler. Remember, since he wasn't successful in the WWE title match earlier on tonight, he has an opportunity in the Royal Rumble match, and that's what he's doing at 18.
He brings the plumber's idea of Cleopatra, Vicky Guerrero, out here to the ring.
Vicky can legally be involved out here now, I mean, or at least accompany him to ringside. She's not banned from this matchup. And Dolph Ziggler, who came so close to winning the WWE Championship earlier tonight, goes right after Kofi Kingston. I am still in awe of what we saw earlier, the way that Kofi survived doing a handstand. They're literally walking his hands on the floor to the steps and stay in this matchup.
Absolutely amazing. Kofi Kingston still in this thing. I thought Kofi was done for sure. Somehow The Miz still in this thing, but the great cut. Hey!
Utico, did he?
I thought Booker eliminated, but no.
No, the official's right there. Utico stayed in there. Both feet did not hit the floor there.
Booker hanging and tough. I got it. Well, you mean you wouldn't like to see your broadcast partner for SmackDown, Booker T, go on to WrestleMania, headline WrestleMania?
No, because then I'd have to listen to him every week. Bad enough sitting out here with him as it is. Pitiful. Oh, Booker. Booker's still hanging in there, though. He lasted longer than you did.
Look at Great Khali. Well, when it's all said and done, I won't have done worse than what 29 superstars.
That's true. Who is number 19?
What? There he is!
The winner of the very first Royal Rumble.
He's back!
In 1988, the Hall of Famer, Hacksaw Jim Duggan!
That's it!
Oh! And look at Duggan go! Listen to this place! It is insane in St. Louis!
Duggan taking care of business here. USA chant going throughout this arena. Oh, yeah.
And look at Duggan go.
A meeting of the minds between Cody and The Miz. USA! Jim Duggan, 25 years later.
Duggan is still going strong. Uh-oh, look at this. Duggan.
Watch it, Jim. Watch it, Jim.
By Cody Rhodes.
This Cody Rhodes is really beginning to get on my nerves. What a story that would have been.
Good try, Duggan. So long. Go back to your retirement home. And look at this. Khali's got Booker in trouble. Right there in front of us. Ziggler as well. And Cody, and there goes Khali and Booker.
Man, my favorites are falling by the wayside.
Who is going to enter at number 20? Who's going to enter at number 20? I think I know. I've got a hunch. Yes!
What?
Yes!
Oh, tell me this is not so.
Not in the rumble.
Keep your pants on. Nobody wants to see it. Get it. Just get up there.
Just go like that. Just go. Get out of here.
Oh, this is
ridiculous.
This may be the most ridiculous thing. Oh, you don't need those earmuffs.
Man, King, I was that close to winning the rumble.
Booker, you did great. But look at this clown.
Man. I was that close.
Look at Cole. He actually thinks he's going to win this thing and go to WrestleMania. The Miz has just passed the 30-minute mark. I don't expect The Miz to try to eliminate Cole, their best buds.
I'm going to tell you, that's a test right there, the last 30 minutes. But
look at Cole avoiding any contact with anybody.
Look at his stomach. I mean, it looks like he's been eating donuts all month.
That's the way he works out. Somebody get in there and get him.
Oh, they just break it all.
What? Wait a minute. Am I seeing what I think I've seen?
Get it.
Karma!
King, check this out. This is only the third time something like this has ever happened. Karma is about to break somebody off a little something proper like, dog.
Oh, I hope she goes right after Cole.
I hope she just eat him like a piece of chicken.
Michael Cole is already crying. I see tears running.
Oh,
yes. She knocked his headgear right off.
She's looking at that boy like a chicken bone. She finna eat.
Oh, look at Cole.
Geek. Give me some, dog. Give.
Look at this conference. interpretation.
Wow! Oh my goodness, Dolph Ziggler just did the impossible. Wow.
Vicky Guerrero is loving it. Karma is eliminated, but what a showing.
Go, you okay? You okay?
You guys just cost me my spot at WrestleMania. I was going to win the thing.
I tried to help you out, dog.
I didn't want to touch a woman. That's why I climbed over the top rope.
Oh, I see. Okay.
Oh, here comes my number one pick to win the Rumble right here. Sheamus, that Celtic warrior coming in to do business.
I may agree with you. Here's Sheamus.
What did you agree with? You said Miz was going to win it. What are you talking about?
I think he is, and I think Dolph is too. And so I think Cody. Oh, look at Sheamus go. Getting some information. I'm pretty proud of this. Booker, first off, congratulations.
Thank you.
You lasted longer than any of the announcers in the 2012 Royal Rumble match.
You know what? I feel good about that.
And guess who was second?
Who's that?
I lasted almost as long as you.
What?
You knew who lasted the least amount in the match?
Who's that?
Lawler.
No, you weren't
and
even
Kofi Kingston's been eliminated.
You weren't even in there 90 seconds.
By Sheamus, longer than you. And you cost my spot at WrestleMania. Nonetheless, here's Sheamus, the Great White, who's eliminated Kofi, turning his ire on Cody Rhodes.
Here comes Sheamus. Sheamus is going to town right here. I like this right here. I just call this a beatdown, and Sheamus is rocking this boy.
Cody Rhodes trying to block those massive blows.
Come on, guys, give some credit. Miz is still in this thing.
Ooh. I'm giving him some credit right now because he's doing a hell of a job taking a beating by this boy Sheamus.
Who is entering now, ladies and gentlemen?
Oh, you didn't know?
Oh, my!
You gotta love it.
Somebody.
You gotta love it, Road Dogg.
At number 23, Road Dogg and the New Age Outlaws. You and Generation X is here.
Look at the people going nuts.
And look at him go, go, Dogg, go. Little shake, rattle, and roll, baby.
I wanna see him shimmy. I wanna see Road Dogg do that shimmy like he always has. Check him out, here it is right here, bam. That is right here. Shimmy!
Boom, boom! Yeah!
Beautiful, baby. That boy can go.
Oh, does this bring back memories? Cody Rhodes, ladies and gentlemen, has just made it over 30 minutes. Miz has bettered that. Since Miz entered at number one.
Cody Rhodes eating some turnbuckle.
I tell you, Road Dogg ain't lost a step, dog. He's in there right now, and he's going strong, man.
So again, Cody Rhodes over 30 minutes, Miz over 33 minutes. Ooh. In the 2012 Royal Rumble matchup. What a match for those two so far.
Listen to the people, you still got it. You still got it. And I'm gonna tell you, Road Dogg still got it, dog.
Were they chanting that for me when I was in there?
No.
No, you never had it. That's what they were chanting.
Okay, I beat you at WrestleMania and lasted longer in the Rumble.
Oh, please, go.
I'm almost out to save on my peak. And everything they said was out of my reach. So close to heaven. Jey
Uso is in the ring right now.
What happened to the Uso brothers? Great tag team here in the WWE.
Wait a minute, he's going to try to show Road Dogg up with a little boogaloo etch.
Wow. Of course, the son of legendary WWE superstar Rikishi.
And there it is,
paying homage to Rikishi.
Road Dogg is out.
Well, not technically. He's still in the Rumble. But he may be knocked out. Sheamus trying to eliminate Dolph Ziggler over here.
Gotta give it to Cody Rhodes. He's in there tooth and nail. I mean,
are you gonna say something nice about Miz?
I mean, the guy's banging out. Miz, of course, Miz is in there, hanging in there like a true champion. He is. I like that. These guys are going one on toe to toe in here in this ring. I like it. These guys are going at it.
Road Dogg, a five-time tag team champion, standing toe to toe with Ziggler. Hey, Road Dogg, go. Miz still hanging in there, as is Cody.
can't concentrate for the screaming by Vicky Guerrero.
I mean,
here.
She's just cackling, man. I mean, she's going off.
Can you believe that Miz could do this? Miz could last from number one and win this thing, because this is entry number 25 right now.
Oh, man.
And speaking of Vicky Guerrero, another one of her clients. There he is, the United States champion, Jack Swagger.
The all-American American who has been on fire lately has hit the ring, and here he goes. Whoa.
And it's going to be hard to stop a man like Swagger, nearly 270 pounds, 6 foot six. And Swagger and Sheamus, and look at Swagger go with a belly-to-belly to Sheamus, and Swagger's rolling.
Anything, you know Sheamus is in there, is going to battle it out, but I'm going to tell you, this guy right here, Swag, his cardio is going to be totally up, and he's going to be hard to stop in this match right here, man, coming in this late.
Jack Swagger, he's fresh. Look at Road Dogg still in there. Like Road Dogg is trying to tag out. Road Dogg, this is not a tag match. This is a Royal Rumble, buddy.
Bro, you always say it's a young man's game, you know, but Road Dogg has the experience to last in this match.
So, by the way, if it's a young man's game, then you and Jerry should not have gotten in the match. Nonetheless,
you've got no room to talk about who shouldn't have been in the match.
So, what are you, 60 years old? You're 58?
You were 60. You were a total joke.
What do you think of JR? Right now, there are seven men in this match. Swagger, Uso, Ziggler, Sheamus, Miz, and Road Dogg.
And who is next?
Who's it gonna be?
Only five men remain. At number 26, my pick for the Rumble. Wade Barrett, the Barrett Barrage.
I like this guy right here. He has been on the roll ever since, you know, breaking off, you know, from those guys. What were those guys, Nexus?
I don't like anything about
the core.
And the core, just breaking off of those guys. This guy right here, Wade Barrett, has stepped up.
And again, you know, you look at a guy like Wade Barrett. Last year, his first Rumble match, he lasted 22 minutes with a late entry this year. This could be the year for Barrett. And Wade Barrett going after everybody in his path.
You ask what the strategy is in a matchup like this. I'm going to tell you what the strategy is.
I asked that an hour ago.
I'm telling you right now. The strategy is come in.
Road Dogg! Wow,
come in at number 30. That's the strategy.
Oh, you didn't know. It's time to go.
Oh, Wade Barrett. I love the Royal Rumble match. It is so unpredictable. This silver anniversary this year. Great to see Hacksaw Jim Duggan back, the first ever winner.
You know what I can't stand is that we are going to hear for the rest of our lives that Michael Cole competed in a Royal Rumble.
Yeah, the silver anniversary. They needed all the stars. And I lasted longer than you, by the way.
Oh, Cole.
And I beat you at WrestleMania. We can go on and on with this all night.
Can we get off that?
Oh, look at Ziggler. Dolph starting to build some momentum.
Uso is in trouble right now. Just pick him up and toss him gingerly over that top rope.
Who is number 27?
This is the lucky number. Who is it?
Well, I like this.
Oh, man.
The legal advisor for Raw Interim General Manager John Laurinaitis, David Otunga. Heads to the ring at number 27. Listen, guys, Miz, we understand, has been in this matchup well over 40 minutes already. He entered at number one. Now, here's the thing about David Otunga. He's a lawyer, guys. Listen. He won a pro bono case for a man illegally terminated in New York State this past weekend. It runs his record as a lawyer to 20-0. So what do you think about that?
I think I don't believe it.
Why not?
I think he thinks a lawsuit is something you wear to court.
He graduated from Harvard.
I'd have to see the degree. And I'd have to see him in court.
You can read all about that story on WWE.com right now. And you know they don't lie at .com.
Oh, of course not. Who wrote that story? Oh, you?
And? we are waiting three more men into the 2012 Royal Rumble matchup. It is getting down to crunch time, folks. Remember the winner. Well, main event WrestleMania can pick the champion he wants to battle on April 1st in Miami.
And if history means anything, Otunga came in at the lucky number. Four winners of the Royal Rumble came in at number 27.
I'll tell you, the man I'm most impressed in this matchup right here is the zigzag man. Ziggler has been out here earlier and come out here and still hanging in that tooth and nail. This kid might do it tonight.
What about The Miz? I hate to, but who's this?
His own Randy Orton,
the Viper,
and here comes the Viper, and he goes right after Barrett. Barrett, the man who threw him down a set of stairs, causing a herniated disc in
I'm gonna tell you, you wouldn't tell he's got a hernia in this. The Viper, Randy Orton, that man is on fire.
And look at the carnage.
Oh my goodness.
Ladies and gentlemen, Randy Orton, who won the Royal Rumble in 2009, is attacked from behind from a former buddy of his from Evolution, Cody Rhodes. I'm sorry, the legacy that is, the legacy. And look at Orton. And Orton now turns his attention to Ziggler. Randy Orton again won in 2009.
Oh, look at
this. He lasted 48 minutes.
Double up, y'all.
Do it.
Oh! Double DDT by Randy.
Well, he may have had a bad back, but I think he is well and raising hell.
I'm going to tell you, adrenaline has overruled that bad back right now. Adrenaline is what this man is going through.
RKO to Barrett.
Wow.
RKO to Barrett.
And Barrett's
Barrett eliminated by Orton.
Wow. Headlining WrestleMania just went over the top rope.
Just like last year, Barrett falls prey to the Viper. Who is number 29? Champion.
Let me tell you, I got a lot of history with Chris Jericho and this kid right here. I mean, he is one of a kind. He's a guy who leads his own ship. This guy tonight, can he pull it off?
Yeah, the first ever undisputed WWE Champion, Chris Jericho. Now, you look at Miz and Cody. Listen to these stats. Cody Rhodes, over 40 minutes. Miz, over 43 minutes in the Royal Rumble match here tonight.
Wow.
This is an amazing Royal Rumble, full of surprises. Action packed. I love it.
It tells me how much these guys want it, man. These guys are willing to go out here and leave it in the middle of that ring for one thing, a world title shot. Not the championship, but just a shot.
At WrestleMania, as you see Sheamus looking to eliminate Swagger. Chris Jericho, who entered in 2000 at number one. His last Rumble was 2010. We entered last. He lasted nearly 40 minutes. In 2003, as we wait for number 30, the final man to enter the Rumble match.
Well, it's a big show.
Oh, man.
Wow.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, after he suffered disappointment again earlier tonight, when Daniel Bryan slipped from his grasp to escape the cage and retain the world title, Big Show has another opportunity. Oh. See you, Swagger. Bye.
I'm sure the Big Show is thinking all's well that ends well.
Oh, not a punch. Swagger's out cold. And now Big Show is the world's largest athlete.
Watch this right hand again.
Pow!
Oh, man.
Woo-hoo.
He might have broke that boy's jaw right there, dog.
And here's Big Show.
Luck of the draw, man. Coming out number 30. Big Show is in total control right here. This could be Big Show's night right here, man.
And his entire career. There goes Cody.
Yes!
Who's
going to stop it? Who's going to stop this big man right here?
Ladies and gentlemen, with the three eliminations so far tonight in his entire career, Big Show is eliminated.
Oh!
24 superstars in a Royal Rumble match. Make it 25.
He just tossed
his career for Big Show.
He just tossing guys out left and right now, man.
Check it out, guys. We are down to the final four.
Wow. Sheamus, Jericho.
That's my pick.
Big Show in Orton.
Not Big Sheamus, but I'm going to tell you right now, it's hard to call with these four individuals right here. That Big Show coming in at 30, he's fresh.
Big Show twice a runner-up in the Royal Rumble matchup. Orton has won a Rumble. Sheamus and Jericho have not.
Great strategy.
Here we go.
Great strategy. Get the biggest man of them all. Get him up.
Well, it ain't working. Big Show ain't going nowhere.
No, not at all.
Oh, no.
And Big Show.
Jericho's going for the ride.
Remember, they used to be tag team champions.
Whoa!
And Big Show planning Jericho.
I'm going to tell you right now, Jericho hadn't felt one of those in a long time.
Hey, RKO by Randy Orton on the Big Show. Show is down, but not out.
And two of SmackDown's biggest and brightest stars, Sheamus and Orton against another SmackDown star, Big Show.
Whoa. Wow.
Big Show eliminated by Orton.
Wow.
Randy Orton is eliminated by Jericho. And we are down to two men. Chris Jericho and Sheamus.
Wow, my pick Sheamus is still in there, but I'm going to tell you, experience factor goes to Chris Jericho. He knows exactly what it means to be in a matchup like this.
St. Louis is shocked right now over the fact that homegrown Randy Orton was eliminated. But we are down to two. One of these two men, number 28, Chris Jericho, number 22, Sheamus. One of these two men are going to WrestleMania to battle for a championship. This is what this is all about. A chance to go to Miami on April 1st in the grandest stage of all.
Wow. I mean, Randy took his eyes off the prize for just a moment after getting that big man out, and there he went.
We're guaranteed now, folks, to have a first-time winner of the Royal Rumble match tonight. Can you imagine the emotion and the nerves right now inside these two men? Everything at stake. Now that it's a one-on-one matchup, Jerry, does the strategy change at all?
No, it's still survival of the fittest. And it's all about the big prize going to WrestleMania to headline it. So everything is at stake here.
And Chris Jericho. Top rope. Sheamus looking to eliminate Jericho. Jericho trying to hang on. Desperately trying to hang on here. In the corner. Sheamus has got to get Jericho over the top rope where both feet hit the floor.
You know, you gotta feel, I mean, if Sheamus beat Jericho in this match, that's gonna do something for him. I mean, because you know he watched Jericho coming up, I mean, for many years, and to beat him in the middle of that ring, man, that's gonna be big.
And again, Jericho surviving. Now it's Sheamus trying to figure out what to do in this juncture. This will drop kick by Jericho.
Finish Jericho right there. I mean, don't take your eye off this guy because, like I say, he's got a lot of moves. He can go up top. He's agile. He's mobile, versatile. Jericho is the deal, dog.
And what about Sheamus, the great white 6'6", 270 from Dublin, Ireland, the first ever WWE champion born in Ireland.
Boy, this is what makes the Royal Rumble so good. I mean, the stakes couldn't be any higher, and we're down to two.
Wow.
Two great superstars. Neither one of these men ever won a Royal Rumble.
Yeah, and you cannot take chances here. One mistake will cost you. And Sheamus. Oh, and there's the Irish curse backbreaker.
Let me tell you something about Sheamus. He can take it as well as he can dish it out, because I'm going to tell you, this kid, it's going to take a whole lot to get rid of. He's going into his bone right there. It's going to be over with real soon.
Sheamus well aware of what's at stake as he continues to
check it out.
The WrestleMania sign. Chris Jericho on the shoulders. Celtic cross.
This is it.
And no. Sheamus was looking to eliminate Jericho with a Celtic cross. Jericho looking to eliminate Sheamus. Sheamus with one arm hanging on.
Wow.
He's still alive. Referee, perfect position. And now Jericho.
Oh, beautiful.
Sheamus hanging on again. Barely surviving.
Oh,
he's got to roll himself back into the ring.
Yeah,
on the bottom
rope. I'm a day. Jericho cannot believe this match is not over with.
He's got to get in there. Come on,
come
Sheamus.
On,
Sheamus has got to get underneath that bottom rope. He's got to get underneath that rope. He's got to roll himself back in.
I don't think he's capable of pulling a Kofi Kingston. He's not going to do a handstand. He's got to get back in that ring.
Yeah, but Sheamus using pure power there to kick Jericho right in the face.
Let me tell you, Sheamus is the brawler, man.
But he's got to get back in the ring, Booker. He's in dangerous situation
here. Back in the ring.
That's right there.
Battering ram.
I love that move right there. Sheamus just, I mean, 270 pounds flying like a 200 pounder. This guy's agile.
And look at Jericho.
I think Jericho might have lost a tooth right there.
Yeah, Sheamus kicked him in the face. And now Sheamus back in the ring. And now it's Jericho who's in trouble.
Get him up in the air.
Again, the experience in Jericho's corner. Sheamus with the strength factor here. And look at this. Oh, Jericho hanging on the top rope. Come on, Sheamus trying to eliminate him here. Jericho, can he hang on? And he does.
The experience factor right there. Jericho knows exactly what it means.
Oh, and a high elbow. And again, Sheamus with the pro kick.
Missed it.
Went for the pro kick. Jericho, here it comes.
Here it comes.
The walls of Jericho are going to do
him any good. He's going for the walls. He's going to hurt this man right now.
Walls of Jericho. This is a submission maneuver, but it doesn't matter.
If he can hurt Sheamus, he'll be doing himself some justice putting this man in that position.
But guys, you got to remember, Sheamus gets to the rope, but it doesn't force a break in this match. There's no break by getting to the rope here, and Jericho realizing now maybe he's done enough damage. He's done enough damage to Sheamus. Now he can get Sheamus up over the top rope.
18,000 people on their feet here. Who is going to win this Royal Rumble?
Sheamus is in big trouble. It's over.
Jericho. And Jericho hung on somehow.
Wait, watch his feet. Watch his feet.
Look at the referee's right there. The referee is right there. Jericho hanging on. Not eliminated.
Jericho's got to get back in the ring now.
He does. He can't be hanging around in the apron because he's already got over the top rope. Jericho, this
watch
is,
yourself right here, Jericho.
It's so hard. You can't go to the top rope, guys, in this type of match.
Very Jericho. Dangerous. Very dangerous move right here.
Oh, my God. Sheamus is up there as well. What the hell? What are they going to?
Sheamus, I think, wants to suplex Jericho back into the ring.
But he can't. I mean, he's got one leg over the ropes. There's no way he can suplex Jericho back in.
Yeah, he wants to try to get him out off that top rope. Jericho still, if his feet hit the floor, he's gone.
Look at this. He's got to hang on. Both men. Both men on the apron.
Wow.
If one of them slip, it's over.
If both men hit the ground right there, what would have happened?
Now Jericho back in the ring.
Well, we know what would have happened. Precedent was set back in 2005 when Batista and Cena hit the ground at the same time. He had to go to overtime.
He's getting
the Jericho with a cold breaker to the face of Sheamus.
Oh, man.
You gotta give this guy, Jericho, a lot of credit. Been doing his music for the past few years and then to come back here to Royal Rumble. Stand here with this man, Sheamus. That's huge.
And again, look at Jericho. Again, there's no cover here. Remember that.
You got to tell Jericho to remember that.
He almost forgot.
I think Jericho hit his head. I remember when Sheamus kicked him in the head before. Oh, God, did you hear that?
Did I? Unfortunately, for Sheamus, he felt it as well.
And now Jericho's got Sheamus in a bit of trouble. Sheamus is swinging wildly as Jericho continues the offense here. Jericho's got to figure out how to get this huge body over the top.
He's got Sheamus teetering here.
Sheamus trying to hang on. Will Chris Jericho win the Rumble? Jericho go to Mania.
Jericho can get that right arm under the leg. Whoa.
Oh.
That was a bad move.
That is not smart.
That was a bad move.
Jericho did, and here comes Sheamus. Went for the broke kick again. Jericho ducks underneath it. Went for a code breaker.
Sheamus caught him in midair.
Jericho!
Yeah.
Nope, they didn't hit. The referee's right there. His feet did not hit the floor. This match continues.
Once again, Jericho teeters and holds on for dear life.
Broke kick! Sheamus is going to WrestleMania! Gentlemen, the Great White is going to be on the prowl on South Beach. Sheamus is going to WrestleMania.
Didn't I tell you this is my pick right here, the Great White Sheamus, that Celtic warrior, a guy who has done so much. 2012 is going to be great for this young man right here.
The luck of the Irish prevails tonight.
Boy, I'll tell you, this thing was back and forth. Could have gone either way. Sheamus almost went out at one point. And then finally, well, you see, Jericho almost went out a couple of times. He teetered on the very edge. But then finally, Jericho goes for the code breaker. Sheamus so strong. Didn't get him there. But he got him here.
Watch Sheamus. A broke kick. Jericho's eliminated. Sheamus is going to WrestleMania, and the question now, guys, is, well, what title will Sheamus focus on?
Congratulations. What a night.
Ladies and gentlemen, Sheamus is the winner of the 2012 Royal Rumble.